BV3 and 4-way S-series ball valve assembly. Slide the thrust washer over the valve stem. Carefully assemble the O-ring over the threads on the valve stem. Use a pick to move the O-ring into the slot at the end of the valve stem. Assemble the three packing rings so that the center piece fits in the grooves of the upper and lower pieces. Press the ring assembly down into the gland of the valve body. Feed the stem assembly into the valve body and push up through the valve gland. Make sure the packing is still flush with the base of the gland. Slide the gland ring over the valve stem. Place the first spring washer angled down over the stem and the second angled up. Apply food grade anti-seize to the stem thread. Thread the locking gland nut onto the valve stem flat side down. Use a pliers to secure the valve stem and bring the nut down to the valve pad. Rotate the valve stem so that the tab faces the large opening. The flow path markings on the valve stem must match the flow path of the ball. Align the groove on the ball and the valve stem and slide into the large part of the valve body. Align the stem notch on the seat with the center line of the valve stem. Press the seat and body seal into the valve body. Rotate the body 180 degrees and repeat the procedure with the other large seat and body seal. Rotate the valve body to the port that is opposite the stop pin hole on the valve pad. Press the small encapsulated seat into the port. Rotate the valve body to the remaining port opening. The small seat and plug insert will always be used for a 3-way ball valve assembly. For a 4-way ball valve assembly, only use the small encapsulated seat. For a 4-way ball valve, an additional clamp end will be used here. To continue with the 3-way ball valve assembly, press the plug insert into this small encapsulated seat. Lay the cover plate over the plug insert. Apply food grade anti-seize to the body bolts. Hand tighten the 4 body bolts and lock washers. Rotate the valve body 90 degrees and align the clamp end port ID with the ID of the ball. Apply food grade anti-seize to the bolts and hand tighten. Rotate the valve body 90 degrees and repeat the procedure with the next end. Rotate the valve body 90 degrees and rotate the valve stem for visual alignment. Repeat the procedure with the remaining clamp end. Secure the valve assembly in a vise. Slide the Dixon Delrin assembly tool through the valve port and into the ball for perfect alignment. Completely tighten the bolts in a star pattern. Remove the assembly tool and rotate the valve and secure in the vise. Rotate the valve stem so that a port in the ball is open to the clamp end. Align with the assembly tool and repeat the tightening procedure on the bolts. Remove the assembly tool and rotate the valve in the vise to the remaining valve port. Rotate the valve stem so that the ball port is aligned with the clamp end. Insert the assembly tool and repeat the tightening procedure. Remove the assembly tool. Rotate the valve in the vise with the cover plate facing up. Repeat the tightening procedure. Remove the valve and secure the valve upright in the vise. For gland nut tightening, prevent ball rotation with a small block of wood or the Dixon Delrin assembly tool. Use a socket to tighten the gland nut just below the valve pad. Remove the assembly tool. Use a square socket and a torque meter to check the torque at the valve stem. The torque meter should read between 0.85 and 1.15 of the brake torque of the valve. If the reading is outside of the range required, loosen or tighten the gland nut as necessary and recheck with the torque meter. When the torque reading is correct, test the flow path to make sure that it is set up for a 90-degree valve rotation. Place the spring washer angled down over the valve stem. Assemble the handle in the direction of the center valve port. Assemble the stop pin and tighten with a screwdriver. Assemble the handle nut flat side down and tighten with a socket. Rotate the handle to make sure that the flow paths are correct. BV three-way S-series ball valve assembly complete.